Andrew Carnegie was a top industrialist, business magnate, and a well-known philanthropist. One of the richest men and the founder of the Carnegie Steel Company, Andrew was among the wealthiest and most famous industrialists of all time, and millions of people have benefited from Carnegie's foresight and generosity. He had to go through many obstacles and hardships in life, but he never gave up. Let's hop into the life of the American legend, Andrew Carnegie. Shaped by poverty, Andrew Carnegie was born in Dunfermline, Scotland in 1835. When Carnegie was 13, his father had fallen on very hard times as a handloom weaver, and making matters worse, the country was struck by starvation. Struggling to make ends meet, the Carnegies moved to Pennsylvania, USA for a better prospect of life. Carnegie's first job was as a bobbin boy, changing spools of thread in a cotton mill 12 hours a day in Pittsburgh cotton factory, and was only given $1.2 per week. He later left the job. In 1849, Carnegie became a telegraph messenger boy in the Ohio Telegraph Company. He was a hard worker and developed the ability to translate signals by ear. Without the use of paper slip and with an ear, he was promoted to an operator. Carnegie had a passion for reading, which was given a boost by James Anderson, who opened a library, and Carnegie was a self-made man in his economic and intellectual development. His capacity and willingness for hard work soon bought him many opportunities. When Andrew turned 18, he was employed as a secretary operator by a railroad company, where he gained a lot of experience, and at 24, he became the superintendent of the Pennsylvania Railroad. He started investing in trading companies and made use of his strong connections as he established his business that supplied rails, bridges to the railroad. In 1883, Carnegie bought the rival Homestead Steelworks and combined his assets with his associates, and in 1892 launched the Carnegie Steel Company. Carnegie Steel Company became the largest and most profitable industrial enterprise in the world in the 1890s. Carnegie made his fortune in the steel industry, controlling the most extensive iron and steel operation ever owned by an individual. Despite being uneducated, Andrew promoted education in every corner. Carnegie founded around 3,000 libraries all around the world. In 1800, Carnegie gave $2 million to start Carnegie Institute of Technology. In 1901, he gave a whopping $10 million to establish the Carnegie Trust for the Universities of Scotland. He also donated large sums of money to Dunfermline, the place of his birth. Andrew Carnegie died on 11th of August 1919 in Lenin, Massachusetts. In his final days, Carnegie suffered from pneumonia. Before his death, Carnegie had donated almost $350 million for various causes.